There are several observations. Participants observed as follows. One, the terrible security situation in the country that threatens the corporate existence of Nigeria. The collapse of national security has led Nigeria to begin sharing sovereignty with terrorist gangs and rogue elements. We look at the lack of vision, capacity, ability and competence on the part of the ruling APC, which has driven Nigeria towards a failed state through incessant borrowings. The Muhammad Buhari regime has returned Nigeria to the status of a beggar and a debtor nation. The collapsed economy, infrastructure, and the comatose manufacturing sector under the APC regime have pushed over 30 million people into unemployment and underemployment between June 2015 and now. From the largest economy in Africa as at May 2015 when the PDP was in power, Nigeria under APC has suffered through recessions and become the poverty capital of the world. The unprecedented nepotism and divisiveness of the APC federal government is fueling separatist tendencies in the country. Nigeria cannot survive another 4 years of APC misrule. The PDP must put its house in order to win the trust of Nigerians and be seen as a serious alternative to the APC, the third APC administration. We have to make Nigeria a workable and functional federation. An imperative by the incoming PDP government to restructure Nigeria. The participants in the retreat made the following vital recommendations, among others. One, that the incoming NWC should hold periodic retreats and roundtable dialogues to clarify its position on issues affecting the country. That the NWC to commence sustained dialogue with the Nigerian electorate before the next round of elections. That the PDP should engage different segments of the voting population, especially to encourage youths and women demographics to the rescue and recruitment process. The new leadership of the party should be in line with the party's slogan to return the PDP to the people by entrenching the culture of internal democracy as envisaged by the party's founding fathers. The new party leadership should enthrone the principle of party supremacy in the PDP so as to enhance order, discipline, unity, unanimity of purpose, and ultimately landslide victories from 2023 and beyond. Members at all levels will rally around the new leadership so that it effectively reforms the positions, re-energizes, retools, and redirects the party towards regaining her lost glory and rescuing the country. PDP to see an emergency need for economic recovery and diversification through appropriate fiscal and monetary policy implementation approach that will help grow the nation's export potentials, stabilize the foreign exchange regime, and present an attraction for local and foreign investments. The new NWC should, as a matter of urgency, revive and retool the People's Democratic Institute, that is the research wing of the party, as the brain box, the research and policy arm. The incoming leadership of the party should explore alternative sources of funding for the party through registration fees, annual dues, statutory contributions, sales of mementos, etc. 10. The task of rescuing and rebuilding the nation is a national emergency. It requires sacrifice, dedication, laser focus, and the cooperation of all. Outgoing NWC praised the incoming NWC led by the PDP national chairman and my honorable self for organizing a very successful retreat with quality attendance from all over the country. Noted that the fruitful deliberations and all of the boss prescriptions are all indications of PDP's best and resurgence. The incoming NWC in return thank its outgoing counterpart for its cooperation and full support. We equally commended party faithful, especially elected governors under its banner, for making out time to attend the retreat and strategize on the way forward. We assure Nigerians and the international community that under the leadership of the PDP, Nigeria shall rise again.
Thank you very much.